factoring tricks with the GCF. We always want to factor the GCF, or the greatest common factor. First, so if we take a look at our two examples here, if we look at our numbers, they're both divisible by 9, so I can pull 9 out. And our rule for variables is always going to be the lowest exponent. So we're going to pull out an x, and that's going to leave us with x squared minus 9. Now I need to look at this again. Notice that inside my parentheses, I have a difference of squares. So that means that can still be factored. So I need to do that first, is write down my parentheses, take the square root of my x, the square root of my 9, put plus in one, minus in the other, and now it's finished. There's nothing else I can factor, so we're done with that. If I look at example 2, if I'm looking at my numbers here, I can see that they all have a common factor of 2. And no, they don't have x's in common, but it looks like they all have a y in common. So let's pull out the y. We do that, that's going to leave us with x squared minus 6x plus 9. So now I have a trinomial in there, and I need to look and see if I can factor that. It just so happens, if you might notice, that I can take the square root of the first term and the last term, so it's probably a perfect square trinomial. So if I do my 2y, square root of the first term is x, square root of the last term is 3, and so is the middle term 2x times 3 equal to 6x? Yeah, it is. So that means it is a perfect square trinomial. So I just bring down the sign in the middle and write a square on the outside, and it's factored. If you didn't notice that it was a perfect square trinomial, remember that you still can factor it as like you would a regular trinomial. Just remember to put your answer in this form when you get done.